So friends, in yesterday's class, we have studied the time temperature transformation diagram and how it is plotted. So there is a procedure for plotting of TTD diagram. So in this diagram, that whatever may be the phase present, what is its process, what is the start time, finish time, and what is the hardness. So starting from austenite to perlite, austenite to bainite, or austenite to martensite, how phases are produced, all together are shown on single diagram. That's why this is time temperature transformation diagram. All the experiments carried out are at constant temperature. That's why it is called as isothermal transformation. So for example, in previous class I told you, one example, T1, capital T1 temperature was 650. So incubation period was carried out, start time, finish time. Then second experiment was carried out, capital T2, where the temperature of start and finish was different. Then time incubation period reduces as temperature T2 reduces. So earlier it was 650, then it becomes 600. Then I carried out third experiment at 400 degrees Celsius, where T3 is less than T2. Again, it is observed that incubation period further reduced. If you go on continuing the experiment, it is observed that at further lower temperature, the incubation period, instead of go on decreasing, it go on increasing. So initial incubation period decreases and then it go on increasing. So that reason today we are going to study. So by the time whatever figures we have drawn, the next figure, I made one statement last time. Initially, as temperature decreases, incubation period decreases, rate of transformation increases. But this but is important. As temperature decreases, the rate of diffusion also decreases and rate of transformation increases. Rate of transformation decreases. So initially rate of transformation increases, then rate of transformation decreases. So how it is plotted? Check. Before that, you just write down the statement. From above figure. So above figure means, I have drawn this figure you have drawn. This is T1, T2, T3. Then again T4 is coming here and T5 is coming here. See here. T1, T2, T3 and T4 and T5 are coming to right hand side of T1 because incubation period increases. This figure. So below this figure immediately write down. From above figure, it is observed that initially incubation period go on decreasing with decrease in transformation temperature in bracket T1 comma T2 comma T3 capital T1 T2 T3 transformation temperature bracket complete. Go to next slide. Further, when transformation temperature decreases, below certain temperature, in bracket T4, T5, below certain temperatures in a bracket T4, T5, bracket complete, incubation period increases. Incubation period increases. In bracket, small T4 and small T5. In bracket, small T4 and small T5. Incubation period increases. Bracket complete. Hence, rate of transformation decreases. Make underline two word, rate of transformation decreases. Full stop. It is as shown in figure below. Draw this figure and give me. Over. I think it is over. Over.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now try to understand the meaning of this curve. I have drawn A and B, two curves, and one average curve is drawn. So whatever paragraph you have written upper, same figure I have drawn here, and now I will explain you meaning of A and meaning of B. So I repeat once again, as temperature of transformation decreases, rate of transformation increases. Second, as temperature of transformation decreases, rate of transformation also decreases. Now, what is meaning of A and B and why this is happening? Very simple thing. As see, we have discussed FCC is converted into BCC plus Arthurumbic. That is, austenite is converted into ferrite plus cementite. So austenite is nothing but FCC, means group of FCC atoms. So group of FCC atom is rearranged in such a way that group of FCC atoms rearranged in such a way that that structure becomes BCC and orthorhombic. But when structure is to be adjusted, atom have to move. Okay, now this depends upon energy level. You are at 850 degrees Celsius, higher temperature, means in the austenitic zone. And if you are cooling that to the lower temperature directly, so delta T is more. More the delta T, more the rate of transformation. This is simple logic. As delta T is more, rate of transformation is more as incubation period decreases. This is simple statement. But what is contradictory statement to it? Even temperature decreases, energy difference is more, delta T is more, but physically movement of atom becomes difficult at lower temperature. FCC group converted into BCC and orthorhombic means atom have to move here and there. Once atom will move here and there, then only FCC arrangement converted into BCC and orthorhombic. Unfortunately, at lower temperature, atomic movements become dull. So diffusion rate decreases. As temperature decreases, movement of atom decreases, means diffusion rate decreases. Once diffusion rate decreases, atom will move very slowly. And if they will move very slowly, FCC will not be easily converted into BCC and orthorhombic. Means incubation period will be less, incubation period will be more, and as incubation period is more, transformation will not finish earlier. So bottom line, this curve, initially rate of transformation increases and again it go on decreasing. So here it is shown, initially as temperature decreases, rate of transformation increases because of energy difference increases. But below certain temperature, even temperature decreases, rate of transformation also decreases, because below that temperature, movement of atom becomes negligible and hence incubation period is more. Now, above this, different phases are formed, and below this, different phases are formed. That will be explained in the next diagram. So all experiments are plotted together commonly. So figure number you give. The figure which you have drawn before this, that is at transformation and temperature you have shown. Transformation and time you have shown. But effect of temperature is not shown in that diagram. I repeat once again, the figure which you have drawn before this figure, rate of transformation and incubation period, that is time, was shown. Effect of temperature was not shown. So out of three capital T's, one T is missing. So how to draw all T's together, time, temperature and transformation, that is explained in the next diagram. May I read this?
Yes, sir.
Now use some full size of the page, half of the page, minimum half of the page you utilize to draw good quality diagram. Thank you. temperature versus time. Now this is A3 temperature, this is A1 temperature. So what is our steel? Our steel is utempered steel. Okay, so for utempered steel, A3 temperature is equal to A1 temperature. So for your understanding, I have drawn separate line. I will show only A1 temperature. Now we have selected 5 temperature baths in which we have cooled our samples. Which are these temperature baths? Capital T1, capital T2, capital T3, T4, T5. Okay. Now I will show capital T1 on this temperature. So it is 650 degrees Celsius. So here it is capital T1. Okay. So at capital T1, I will draw a straight line. So experiment number 1, which you have carried out for 650 degrees Celsius, time transformation starts at some small T1 and finishes at another temperature. So very first figure which you have drawn. So this is first incubation period. Transformation starts. So this figure which we have drawn. This is transformation start and this is transformation finish. Okay. So this time is different and this time is different. These two times I am showing on same axis because temperature is constant. Transformation starts at this time and finishes at this time. Transformation starts, transformation finish. This is the incubation period. Now when I have selected T2 temperature, what happened at that time? Incubation period was less than T1 or more than T1? Answer it now before I show anything. My question is, as for second experiment, that is T2 degree Celsius. So this is 650 degree Celsius, this is 600 degree Celsius. So for 600 degrees Celsius, initial incubation period decreases or increases? Answer it.
Decreases.
Correct. Incubation period decreases. So I will show it here. So this is incubation period for capital T1 temperature. And this is incubation period for capital T2. So then transformation starts and transformation finishes. Same thing for T3. Transformation starts and transformation finishes. T4. Now if you check T4, the incubation period will start increasing. T5, incubation period will start increasing. T6, incubation period will again start increasing. So this is the incubation period start increasing is effect of small b. Okay. Now these left hand side points are start temperatures and start transformation, and right hand side are finish transformation. For example, you have carried out experiment T1 temperature. So I have given example of 8 seconds transformation starts. Okay, I hope you are recalling. At 8 seconds, transformation starts, and then at 20 seconds, transformation is over. So 8 seconds to 20 seconds, austenite will go on converted into the phase perlite. And after 20 seconds, I told all samples will convert into perlite. So this is transformation start and this is transformation finish. In between, so here is austenite, here is perlite, and in between here there is a austenite plus perlite. So what I will do, I will join all star points and I will join all end points. And here this P6 is very less, 300, 250 something, and here is 200 degree Celsius. Below 200 degree Celsius, it is very difficult to obtain the phase bainite or upper light, and it will be marked inside only. So now, very simple, this is C curve, this is called as TTT diagram, time, temperature and transformation. You will ask, where is the transformation? See here, initially this whole left hand side is austenite, this is gamma, this is also gamma. Now here gamma plus P, and here is a P. Here gamma plus B, and here is a B, and here is gamma plus M. Martensite plus austenite means at higher temperature your complete movement, now listen carefully, at higher transformation temperature movement of atom is complete, means complete FCC is converted into complete BCC plus orthorhombic. As temperature is higher, there is sufficient time for movement of the atoms. As temperature of transformation is higher, there is sufficient time for movement of the atoms, and hence all FCC is converted into mixture of BCC and orthorhombic. But as temperature decreases, now you are at 334, perlite is perfect alpha plus efficacy. Here perlite is alpha plus efficacy. Here bainite is also alpha plus iron carbide, but that iron carbide in bainite is little higher carbon content. So here it is little difficult to grasp, but you have to remember perlite is, here I am writing alpha plus Fe3C. Perlite is alpha plus Fe3C, and bainite is alpha plus Fe 2.4C. Bainite is nothing but, I will explain the meaning. Bainite is nothing but very fine structure than perlite, and it is alpha plus Fe 2.4C. This is called as iron carbide, and this is called as epsilon carbide. For every one carbon atom, there are three iron atoms. Here, for every one carbon atom, there are three iron atoms. Here, for every one carbon atom, it is shared by 2.4 iron atoms. Logically, answer, where is carbon rich? Whether Fe2.4C or Fe3C? Logical answer. Answer. One carbon atom is shared by three iron atoms, and one carbon atom is shared by 2.4 iron atoms. Means contribution is here more. That's why this is more rich in carbon than this. Even you are observing single carbon atom, but shared by 2.4 iron atoms only, and here shared by three iron atoms. That's why bainite structure is little harder than perlite structure. Bainite structure is harder than perlite structure. So austenite plus perlite, austenite plus bainite. If you go carefully, listen to me carefully now. This capital T1, T2, T3, T4. I have reached up to, suppose T7, temperature is 200. At that temperature, movement of atom is not only negligible, but it will not move. So FCC structure converted into BCT without shifting the location of atom, because at lower temperature 200 degrees Celsius, movement of carbon as well as iron atom is very negligible. Hence, austenite never converted into perlite or bainite, because if you want to convert into perlite and bainite, you want movement of atoms. For movement of atoms, FCC should be converted into BCC and orthorhombic. Without movement of atom, it is not possible. Then, see my palm. So this is layer of the atom or layer of the atoms. Okay, all atomic layers, you are at 800 degrees Celsius temperature. And at 800 degrees Celsius temperature, suddenly you dipped into 150 degrees Celsius. There is no time for movement of atom, and atomic layers will just slip like this. Just slip like this. Because of just slipping of the atomic layer, FCC structure disturbed and new structure formed, that is called as BCT. And it is harder than bainite and perlite. That new structure BCT is martensite, which is very disturbed and which is not having uniform arrangement of the atoms. So that's why, like BCC and FCC. So body-centered tetragonal structure is obtained from face-centered qubit just by one slip. That's why this transformation is also called as slip transformation. We are not having in detail all these things, slip transformations, etc. You have to just remember that at lower temperature, there is no time for movement of the atoms, and hence BCC orthorhombic is not possible, but FCC is converted into BCT by shear transformation. And now you have 100% FCC here, directly cooled at low temperature just by shifting. All FCC never converted, practically empty. Just by shifting in this way, all FCC never converted into all BCT. So it may convert into 90% BCT. And at room temperature, 10% FCC remains as it is. And that's why it is shown gamma plus M. 90% martensite and 10% austenite. FCC remains as it is. And this austenite, which is present at room temperature, is called as retained austenite. Remember this. Martensite is harder phase. If you measure the hardness of the phases from this side, here is the hardness. So hardness increases from perlite to martensite. Now, if you are at T1 temperature, perlite is little fine. So it is called as fine perlite. FP, fine perlite. Little lower temperature, it is coarse perlite. What is difference between fine perlite and coarse perlite? See the fingers. Ferrite cementite. If the gap between ferrite and cementite larger, then it is called as coarse perlite. C-O-A-R-S-E. C-O-U-R-S-E. It is C-O-A-R-S-E. Means larger gap between the. This is coarse perlite. Then bainite. Upper bainite and lower bainite. And martensite. So five phases I have shown here. Fine perlite, coarse perlite. Sorry. Yes. Course for light, time for light. Course for light is upper. Course for light, time for upper by light, lower by light, and margin side. So hardness increases from course for light to margin side. Course for light is softer, and margin side is harder. Draw this figure. Are you observing the PPT slide? Hello?
Yes,
are you observing
sir.
One PPT slide?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, if you observe it carefully, I hope you are observing cursor also. See this diagram. Left hand side, gamma gamma is shown in the microstructure. And as you are moving from point C to point D, in between, austenite is converted into perlite and again 100% perlite. So alpha plus epicris is separately shown. Pure cementite. It is blue color is cementite and red color is ferrite. So mixture is alpha plus epicris, and it is written coarse perlite. So in this way, left hand side to right hand side transformation takes place, and your actual PPT diagram. Looking like this. Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Abhinay.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And now you can take screenshot also. I have taken right hand side you are observing hardness RC. RC is unit of hardness, Rockwell hardness C scale, 11, 32, 30 and 40. So hardness value go on increasing. A, A stands for austenite. Austenite plus ferrite plus cementite. Ferrite plus cementite is actually perlite. In P directly, they have shown F plus C. C is not carbon. Don't F plus C here. Whatever I have written, you write P. So I will stop sharing the screen and I will come to the blackboard. So austenite converted into austenite. Austenite, austenite plus bainite, bainite. And austenite plus martensite. Or is it over? What answer?
Yes, sir.
May I go to next?
Sir.
Hello. Is it okay? May I go to next slide?
Yes, sir. Over.
So this is TTT diagram for UTEC third steel. Very simple thing. We have carried out experiment at constant. So austenite is converted into perlite at constant temperature T1. T1 is separate experiment, T2 is separate experiment. Then we got bainite at T3 and T4, separate experiment. At constant temperature, this transformation takes place. That's why this is IT diagram. But in actual, before the casting, so you have mold, and in that mold you are going to pour the molten seal. So you are pouring at 850 degrees Celsius or 900 degrees Celsius, and you are keeping in atmosphere as it is for the cooling. So you are not maintaining it at constant temperature. Once casting is solidified, after solidification, this pouring part is not part of metallurgy. So once casting is, once casting is solidified, it will go on cooling in the room temperature. So that cooling starts from suppose 1000 degrees Celsius up to 25 degrees Celsius at room temperature. So that cooling is continuous cooling. At that time, transformation starts at one temperature and finishes at other temperature. So this is called as continuous cooling transformation. And in normal circumstances, continuous cooling takes place. So I will draw now next diagram, and there is no far difference in both the diagrams, only little change. You will see the difference now. Erase it. Sorry, I will erase it, you don't erase it. So CCT diagram. Write down the full form. Continuous cooling transformation. So this is first TTT I have drawn.
जी ओके प्रोसेस
भाई अब बोलते हैं पे अटेंशन नाउ जस्ट आई एम टेकिंग द रेफरेंस ऑफ टीटीटी फॉर एक्सप्लेनिंग द सीसीटी बिकॉज़ देयर इज नो फार डिफरेंस एट टीटीटी डायग्राम ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन स्टार्ट्स एट सेम टेंपरेचर एंड फिनिशेस एट सेम टेंपरेचर फॉर एग्जांपल कैपिटल T1 वी हैव टेकन 650 डिग्री सेल्सियस वी आर डिपिंग द सैंपल्स इन द बार ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन स्टार्ट्स देयर एंड फिनिशेस देयर 650 degree Celsius remains 650 only. But in normal circumstances, we are cooling the casting at room temperature. In that case, this cooling, if you start from here, here this line indicates start transformation line, and this line indicates finish transformation line. So as soon as it cuts here, transformation starts. But it is not at constant temperature, it will start coming down. And here transformation finishes. You get per line. Transformation, suppose you are cooling from 1000 degrees Celsius. So 1000 degrees Celsius austenite, 900 austenite, 850 austenite, 800 austenite, 750 austenite, 700. It starts forming per line here. But temperature 700 will not remain constant because casting is cooling. It becomes 680, it becomes 650, it becomes 630, it becomes 600, 550, 500, 430. In this way, temperature goes on decreasing. As soon as perlite transformation starts, suppose at 650, it will go on continuing. So 10% perlite, 20% perlite, 50% perlite, 80% perlite, 100% perlite. By the time when transformation starts at 650, perlite was 10%, and when it becomes 100%, temperature drop from 650 to 550. When transformation starts at 650 and finishes at 550, but product is perlite because you are still in the perlitic range. 550, 500 is perlitic range. So transformation starts here, finishes here. Okay. Second cooling curve. I will little cool fast. I will take second casting. Now it is at 1000 degrees Celsius and I will start cooling in this way. Here transformation starts, here transformation finishes. If you measure the if you see the microstructure of this perlite and this perlite, you will observe that this perlite is coarser and this perlite is finer. Because if cooling rate is faster, perlite will be finer. Okay. Now I will take once again third cooling rate, third sample, third casting I have taken, and I will start cooling in this way. Now here, what is this? This part. Open the previous page. This point, what is we have shown? Answer. Whether we have shown perlite? Yes or no? Please answer. Nobody is answering. Sabruti. Thank you. Hello, am I audible? Okay, so below this point, what is the base? It is, and this is called as nose of CCTV. This is nose. This is called as nose of the curve. So below it, see a transformation starts, but it is not perfect because it is going in the multi-centric zone. So this product at room temperature will be part inside because it will not get time for here. Once again, transformation starts. Whether it is finished? No, because it is not cutting the finishing curve. So here you have to draw one curve, hatch it. This is CCT, continuous cooling transformation, and transformation starts and it is incomplete. Perlite plus martensite means, as like earlier case, around from here transformation starts and start continuing. 50% perlite is formed, but your cooling rate is very fast. Means 600 directly, 500 directly, 400 directly, 200, 300. Means within 2-3 minutes you are coming at room temperature. There is no time for movement of the atoms, and remaining austenite converted into martensite. And if I am coming this way, tell me, what is the phase? This curve. Sir, 5-10 minutes are remaining. I am most time is. Hello. Please answer. Whether perlite will form in this case? Whether perlite will form in this case? You are not answering.
No, sir.
Perlite will not form because you are not cutting this line. Directly austenite is converted into martensite. So now, what is the, this is very fast cooling rate. If you write here, this is 5 degrees Celsius per minute. Means, per minute 5 degrees Celsius drop, 850, 845, 840, 835, 830. Oh, this much slow cooling rate you will get per light. Here cooling rate increases 50 degrees Celsius per minute, 850, 800, 750, 700 in this way. Then this is 150 degrees Celsius per minute. 850, 700, directly 700 to 550, 550 to 400, 400 to directly 250, 250 to directly 100. So within some less time, you are reaching to room temperature. And this suppose 300 degrees Celsius per minute, means 850 to directly, imagine 850 to directly 550, 550 to directly 250, 250 to directly room temperature within 2 minutes, 850 to 200. There is no time for movement of atoms with this fast cooling rate, and there will be only shear transformation, FCC converted into BCT. That's why structure is martensite. Now, what is the optimum cooling rate at which you are getting martensite? It is here. I am drawing with this blue pen. You also draw. This curve just touches the nose of CCT. Just avoids the nose of CCT and gives martensite. If you, now this value is suppose 250 degrees, 50 degrees Celsius per minute. 250 degrees Celsius per minute, if you cool, you will get martensite. more than 250, for all cases you will get Martin side. But if you shift to little left side, you will get perlite plus Martin side. If you shift right, you will get Martin side. So this is the optimum cooling rate, called as critical cooling rate, CRR. Draw this figure immediately. I will dictate this part in next class. You just draw this figure. Definition of CCR. Draw it. Don't. Once your figure will be over, you can leave the room. You can take screenshot also if something is missing. In next, I will dictate the definition of CRR.